There is a very interesting and romantic legend about Halevi, which dates to the 16th century. That's the first time it's found in print. It's found in a Hebrew book that appeared in Italy in, I think, 1586, if I'm not mistaken. And in it, the story is told that Yehuda Halevi reaches the land of Israel, makes the pilgrimage to Jerusalem, comes to the gates of Jerusalem, the walls of Jerusalem, kneels to pray and thanksgiving outside these walls, recites the greatest of his, or the best known of his, songs of Zion, Zion Halotish Ali, Zion, will you ask? And as he's reciting his own poem, full of this yearning for Zion, an Arab horseman, according to the legend, comes galloping by and tramples him to death, so that he dies face down in the dirt of Jerusalem. Halevi really, in some ways, was the first Zionist, or the first proto-Zionist, you might call him. You know, Jews in the Middle Ages, in the early Middle Ages, up to Halevi's time, very few Jews even visited Palestine. It was difficult. I mean, travel was arduous, it was dangerous. There were highwaymen, and there were pirates, and there were diseases, and there were shipwrecks, and there were storms. And very few people made the pilgrimage to, very few Jews made the pilgrimage to Palestine. And those who made it almost all came back. I mean, a fraction of them actually went to live there. Halevi is the first Jew, really, in the entire medieval period, who comes and says, both in his poetry and in his great work of his great defense of Judaism, his book, The Kuzari, who says a Jew should be living in the land of Israel. I feel a personal connection with Halevi, both because I love his poetry, and also because his decision to come live in the land of Israel at a time in history when almost no Jews even considered taking such a step, and when he gave up a really magnificent life of comfort and honor in Spain to come here as an elderly man all by himself and come to a land that was a wilderness and where nothing awaited him but hardship and uncertainty, has always spoken to me, that decision, very deeply, because I myself am someone who, ever since I came to Israel in 1970, has always believed that this is the place where a Jew who really cares about being Jewish should live. And today it's very easy to live here. As much as people gripe and complain about how difficult it is to immigrate to Israel, it's a piece of cake compared to what Yehuda Halevi faced in the 12th century. And to me, his act is really one of the great heroic acts of Jewish history.